Hello and welcome to Stamford Bridge, the home of Chelsea Football Club, and a great big welcome back to the First Division. But this is the match of the century as far as we're concerned here, because on one hand we have the fun-loving, happy-go-lucky celebrities. And on the other hand, the cigar-smoking, beer-swilling, morose Lord's Taverners. On my right hand, the man who does neither, your Uncle Eddie Waring.
Well, the Lord's Taverners are the serious people. The celebrities are all jolly and all that sort of thing, you see. And we've a lot to do. I've got to sail away to the marathon, so if you don't mind, I'll see you later. Goodbye. Yes. Goodbye.
Meanwhile, the teams go with him. Fly to your field. Fly! Fly! Away you go! Away! What a motley crew. It'll be a miracle if we ever get through the games. But on my left, I have the diminutive but sporting captain of the celebrities, Bill Oddie. Bill, you've been rather poorly recently. Bill Oddie's been poorly, folks. You see, sympathy.
I would normally be, of course, out there with the lads and lasses, of course. But unfortunately, I'm going to show them the reason I'm not, because I don't want to be thought soppy. Tim's not here, and he is soppy.
That's the operational scar, which we won't see. Be a goodie and put it away. Yes. When are you coming back?
A 7-inch scar.
I know it is, but when are you coming back?
Yes. I'm coming back in the autumn. I'll be all right to film in the autumn. We'll have a series on in, I think, about November, something like that.
Smashing. In the meanwhile, here is Willie Rushton. What a handsome figure you cut, sir. The skipper of the Lord's Taverners. Tactics today because last year's skullduggery set in.
Oh, no. Clean play. Foully performed, I think, is the keynote of our performance. The lads are stoutly girded, their loins are in wire baskets, they're ready for anything. Crispin, Crispin shall now go by from this day to the end of the world, but we in it shall be remembered.
By Harry, and England and St. George. In the meanwhile, at the marathon is
Edward.
I hope you enjoyed that. Well, that's what the marathon's all about. Going to be sliding down, have water. How many cans of water they can get on that table will eventually settle the marathon. But I don't think I should take it too serious on the score. But you're going to see them fold on 6 occasions. But let's get cracking. First game, let's do it.
Well, yes, indeed. I've got in a sack with me here representing the Lord's Taverners. We have Don McLean and Anita Harris looking very, very cosy. It's a snatch of a song.
This could be the start of something big.
You naughty boy.
Sorry.
And we pass on now to the celebrities. We've got Hilary Pritchard and Bernard Cribbins. Have you a word to say before we embark on this venture?
Yes, we're waiting for a bus, actually. And we're expecting rain, so we thought we'd get into this sack.
Well, here they are, very, very cosy. Stand by, because two more introductions to do. The lovely Brenda Lee steps forward, our score girl. A small kiss on the cheek. And here we have Arthur Ellis. For years he's had short back and sides. And look at this haircut now. It looks like a Roman emperor gone mad. The toast of Halifax. Anyway, they roll down the course, bursting balloons as they go in a most unusual fashion, as Arthur will show you when he blows his whistle.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
Yay, yay, down they go! They roll. Bernard Cribbins is intent on fouling, I'll tell you that from the start. They've come out, Hilary Pritchard's come out, burst out of a costume. Anita and Don bombing along. Don McLean of Cracker Jack, Anita Harris, your lovely chanteuse. Locked in fearsome embrace. It's more like a wrestling match. Goodness knows what's happening underneath there. Hilary Pritchard in the meanwhile's come out again. Bernard, will you behave yourself? Anita Harris and Don McLean there, doing their best. You have 1 minute to go. Come on, Hilary and Bernard. You've got to give a great big push. It's no good rolling. You've got to push hard. Don and Anita. There's a lot of action, but no balloons being... I see a foul there of Don McLean. You see that bursting with his fingers. Push down. Push hard down, Hilary.
Push on. Well, you see the wasters there, the carnage. In the yellow sack, we have Anita and Don. They've done it. Bernard Cribbins is burst one. He gets a round of applause. Shove hard down, Hillary. Go on.
Come on,
Don. Don McCain is finished. We're all finished. Give them some applause, then.
Arthur, the result. And before we come to the result, anyway, let's have a look at Dinah May there. Welcome, please, for Miss Great Britain, Miss Dinah May on the scoreboard. A little ripple of applause, a few faint cheers, and the result.
Yes. For the celebrities, they only scored three. Two of those were by foul means, but we'll still allow the three. And the score for Lord Taverners, 14. So Lord Taverners are the winners. 2 points to Lord Taverners.
2 points to the Taverners. Early blood, lots of booze. And the celebrities?
1 point.
1 point for celebrities and the first round of the marathon, Uncle Eddie.
And the celebrities are already at the top of the ramp. And you're ready with your whistle.
3, 2, 1.
And let the battle commence. Go. Here's a well done. Fraser Hines, the first one. They're doing a little bit of cheating, they're holding on. Come on, young Cheggy. They're swap job, and these are the legs. These are the girls from Legs and Co., top of the pops. Eddie, go on. Well done, Eddie. I'm glad it was this, Eddie, and not you. So the Legs and Co., aye, here comes one special one. Watch this one. Oh, well done. 30 seconds to go. There the Legs and Company. Kate Chegwin. Robin Askwith. Oh. And Eddie Capelli going for the last time. Not a lot of time. You've got to come down, Eddie. Or else you lose your chance of another couple of cases for us here. There we go. You did a great job then.
Not bad.
Did you enjoy it?
I loved every minute of it.
You did.
Cracker Jack!
Advertising. Advertising. Right. Well, how many, please, on the first one?
We still that's it. 19.
19 on the first one. That's par for the course. 19 for celebrities. And over to Stuart.
Thank you, Edward. With me on the celebrities, I have Neil Durden-Smith, a mighty man, ex-Royal Navy, boom-boom, on the end of a rope. Who's on the other end? I'm going to top. Is Chris Ralston another mighty rugby union player? Now, they have to operate a... Hang on, Chris. They operate the skipping rope, and they operate it for 2, 4, 6 of their teammates. You see them there, Ian Lavender, Derek Hobson, Ian St. John, and some of the Legs girls there from Top of the Pops. They come down with buckets, bowls of water, rather, and they have to skip down the course a podium at a time. And on my right, you see the measuring cylinder whence the water goes. All right, lads, are you ready? Arthur, on the whistle.
Ready?
Celebrities.
3, 2, 1.
They rush forward. They line up and they skip.
Get the right side. Right. Right. Next one, quick. Right.
Off! Straight up, Derek, right leg. And of course we can't, that's Derek, there. The girls from Top of the Pops, Ian Lavender. And on the right, that's Ian Lavender, Dad's arm in all that. And they run, the boys run back with the rope, all the contents of the water go in. Fast as you can, girls, come along, sprinty, sprinty. All frills and pink, more bowls coming back. It's a game of 2 minutes duration. These are the celebrities. You cheer the celebrities, a big cheer. Come along, cheer! Oh. And something went wrong. Something didn't quite go right with the celebrities' rhythm there. Get the skip going, chaps. Right side of the line, Ian St. John. Legs go up, 2, 3, and... Oof.
Next one.
Another little run. Lord Stamina's going next.
Go!
Up! Shout up, up, everybody! And up! And again. And... And one more time. And more water still. Running out of time now, celebrities.
Come on, go.
Back to the start. 10 seconds to go. Can you make another way? 10? Can you do it? I don't think so. He'll even make the bowl. And any second now, the whistle goes. A little applause for the celebrities. Come along. Arturo, I shall have to have your pronouncement now. Watch a minute. Oh, just a minute. Just a minute. Come here. You've got a wisp of hair. You little Roman emperor, you.
Yes.
Yes, and the score for the celebrities, 42 marks on the dipstick.
42 on the dipstick, a paralysing score. Willie Rushler there giving advice to his beleaguered teammates of the Lord's Taverners on the starting line, Arthur.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
I think Willie's tied their legs together. Look at this. It won't work. They put covers on their pots. This is the Lord's Taverners. Do we have a boo for them? Do we have a boo for the Taverners? Because they're cheating. They've got covers on their bowls. 42 marks on your dipstick, Robert Wilson, back swiftly. And the girls are from Samset. You've seen them dancing all over your telly screens. Lovely girls. With Bob Wilson, we've got Eric Flynn and Terrence Hardiman. The girls are back first, the fittest of the sextet by far. Give them a little cheer if they do skip. Up. Up. Oh, there's a lot of cheating going on here from the Taverners. Give them a big boo, the cheating. Ooh. You have to watch these Taverners every step of the way. They win at all costs. But there looks a lot of water in there. In the meanwhile, yes. No, I didn't see that. You see, all the cheating comes to naught. But they're a lovely sight. Look at them, not even skipping, just striding over it. There looks to be a lot of water there, Arthur. I should keep your eye on that cylinder, because Arthur Ellis might just come in. Arthur Ellis might just come in and have a look at the cylinder. Lance Percival is coming in to stop any cheating, but meanwhile, Arthur at the bow. Arthur, look at Arthur, behind you! You see, it's no good. It's useless to cheat. You can't beat Arthur Ellis. Bob Wilson, you should know better than to try and cheat Arthur Ellis.
A bit of cheating on certainly
a bit.
On the Lord Taverners.
A lot.
So we had to take some water out. And the score for Lord Taverners, 30, as against Celebrities 42. So
you're
Celebrities
right.
Are the winner.
Aha.
2 points to the Celebrities.
2 points to the Celebrities. And
1 point to Lord Taverners.
1 point to Lord Taverners. So it's 3 apiece and we go to Eddie at the marathon.
It's the Lord Taverners to go for the first time in the marathon. The chase in 19 by the Celebrities on the whistle.
3, 2, 1.
And led by John Jenkin and the Liverpool Express. The Liverpool Express coming down. Tony, Billy, Roger Derrick, and John Jenkin. Come on, John. This is your big moment, boy. Is it been practicing? John Jenkin, you've been practicing, I think. You're not supposed to hold it with your fingers, you know. No. And Roger De Courcey ready to come down in a moment. Dodo coming down. Here comes Roger without his bear. Probably wish he had it. And the Somerset girls, Jill, Desi, with their MD, Anthony, Howard. Talking about very serious. Ooh, she said. Got 30 seconds and you're chasing 90. You're not supposed to hold them. Hey, I like this bit. Well done, John Taylor, that was brilliant. So that's the target, chasing 19. So what's the score?
The Taverners scored 23.
23 for the Taverners, so they take the lead. With, of course, two rounds still to go, and Stuart.
And thank you, Eddie. Now the celebrities will go for them. First of all, Norman Rossington, that well-known actor of stage, screen, and what have you, from my neck of the woods. Meriel Tufnell, European champion women's jockey. Raymond Baxter, of Tomorrow's World, never at a loss for words. Raymond, just a few words from you.
I've got a mouthful of balloons.
He's got a mouthful of balloons, yes. And Gillian Gilks, who is the All England badminton champion. Now, their job, you see, is to carry balloons. They're supposed to have two, only two, but I see already a little cheating. Raymond Baxter has them secreted about his person. So has Gillian Gilks. They're everywhere. But the idea is they've got to stuff their team captain. And it is Bill Oddie. Bill Oddie is on a podium about 20 yards down the course. That's Bill. They've got to stuff him. And the Lord Stamblers obviously will stuff their own team captain, Willie Rushton. And you see, both teams are playing their jokers. Right, Arthur, let us get the celebrities on their way.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
The celebs glancing down. In the van is Norman Rossington. And they stuff the little overall that William Oddie is wearing, full of balloons. And you've seen the end of this game before. Back to the start goes our Norman. But back at Bill Oddie, Gillian Gilks is, with that strong right hand of hers that's won a many a badminton championship, is puffing the balloons in and making a distinctly Oddie shape. Raymond Baxter has succeeded. He comes gleefully back to the start. Start off again. How many balloons can Bill Oddie take before he bursts? Meryl Tufnell. Where is she putting them, I ask myself? That is that's Raymond Baxter. What do you believe, Raymond? What do you see yourself? You'll never believe it. Ex-squadron leader. Battle of Britain pilot, Tomorrow's World interlocutor, and here he is with balloons. Meryl Tufnell, meanwhile. Don't forget the celebrities playing, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, so a large cheer for them now. Now! We reserve our booze for the Lord Taverners who've been prone to cheat. You have 30 seconds to... I can't see where you're going to get them now. Up his boots, in his ears, in his socks. Ten seconds to go. And how many balloons? We have to burst them all. Well, that is the end of the game, and you can see Oddie W, yes. Now then, Meryl, can you just let us point Bill to camera? Yes, applaud them if you will, because Willie Rushton is sharpening up his rusty nail to burst every balloon. I want a little cheer for every pop. Right, okay, Bill. One, two, three, four,
five.
That's not a balloon!
No. It was a terrible operation.
Are you counting some of this?
Oh, Arthur's counting, don't worry about that. Ooh!
Let me rummage about you. Oh, look.
One.
He actually did.
That's a number. Right, Arthur's made up his mind. We've been looking for it whilst they're playing. Tell us how many balloons.
Yes. Actually, apart from the ones that have been burst, they've really cheated again. They've put more in as we've been going along. But actually, they were counted as we were put in. They've caught 26.
26 balloons for the celebrities. And now we'll go the Taverners. The smiling Judith Chalmers, ready for the Taverners, always ready with an eager smile. Start them on their way, they're going to stuff Willie Rushton.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
26 balloons to beat. Linda Cunningham is first away, look at this. She is keen. A bit of cheating from Peter Glaze. And Bernard Bresslaw. Oh, poor old Bernard. Poor Bernard. Oh, that's hurt. He's going to go any second he'll go. Bernard, his hat's on. But back at the action, Willie Rushton is being well and truly stuffed with balloons. Linda Cunningham, what a lovely side, isn't she? That's Bernard, needless to say. I don't think he'll even make a run. You can take bets on it. As sure as Chelsea will stay in the first division, you can bet that Bernard... Eh? You can bet... Poor old... Poor Bernard Bresslaw. I don't think he's going to make it. There he is. I don't think he's going to make... Can he make it? Can he go? Can he make a run? No! And there's Judith. And where she put those balloons? Linda Cunningham coming up on the right. Willie Rushton getting him up his trouser leg. Bernard Bresslaw, and I think he really is girding up his loins. This is the supreme effort. Oh. You've half a minute, Bernard, to do, but don't strain yourself. It's difficult for you fellas who are big, top heavy. Now, don't strain too much. You've got 20 seconds to cover 10 feet. Oh! I want a big cheer if he does it. Will Bernard Bresslaw do it? Will he make it? 10 seconds, Bernard. He's done it! I want a cheer! And you would get it! That was like winning World War II, Bernard, that. And the whistle goes. Oh, Bernard, you did well. Just give him another cheer. Bernard Bresslaw, ladies and gentlemen, look at it. The hero of the day. Oh. Meanwhile, back at Willie Rushton, full of balloons. Bill, come on the left. Willie?
I don't think you're going to hit there, are we?
I think it's improved your figure, you know. No end, Willie.
It's done something for me.
Right, OK, we're starting to burst.
One.
He's bursting with two nails. Don't worry, Arthur Ellis has got this taped.
Oof. Hang on, that was Leigh. Yes, that was one. Yes.
I think that's limb.
That was two!
No, he wasn't!
It was!
No, he wasn't!
You're doing two at a time!
I'm not!
It's a Swiss! Ah! Ah! By my friend's hand! What?
That pink one is me.
Oh!
Yeah, that's gone in there.
Oh!
I didn't know you were Jewish.
Oh, come.
Yes?
Not so much bursting balloons as lancing old war wounds.
Oof. I can just come to the boil.
Two or three here.
Now there's only one there. Perfectly obvious. None there.
There's one here.
There's a big one at the back.
Party going on down by right leg.
There's a big one at the back. That's one.
Ooh! Wait a minute. There's one there.
That's the guy. There are one or two here.
One, two, three.
I'll squeeze while you push. Oh! Oh! That's it! Oh! Oh! No, out!
Well,
Emperor Artemis.
Again, a bit of cheating.
There's always a lot of cheating.
Right. Lord Taverners 35 as against Celebrities 26.
So,
Lord Taverners the winners. They played the joke.
Yes.
The 2 points doubled up to four.
4 points for the Lord's Taverners.
1 point to the Celebrities. They played the joke. Doubled up to two. 2 points to the Celebrities.
Celebrities 2 points. The state of the poll at the moment. The Lord's Taverners 7, Celebrities 5, and to the marathon.
Well, we can't have a joker on the marathon. We've got enough jokers anyway. So we'll dab the whistle and we'll see what the celebrities can do for the second time.
3, 2, 1.
And a pile of celebrities coming down. Ian St. John met a rather tragic clash with Derek Hobson. You're both fit, are you? Come on, girls. You don't have to wait. These are the legs in co. Aye, aye, she said. Come on. First in the long man we've got waiting at the top. Oh, there's some opposition at the top. Oh, no, they're not. We've got Raymond Baxter, my little tough now, and Norman Rossington. And you're less than 30 seconds, Norman Rossington. Come on. Raymond Baxter, you've got to get cracking. Time's not for you.
Come on.
Right. They're carrying a tremendous load. Come on, come on. Hurry up. You've only got 10 seconds. 9, 8, 7. Just a minute. Don't see what he's doing. Well, I asked you. Did you hear the whistle? That's all I don't know, Freeman. The score, please.
The score 11, making the total 30.
Not a very good round for celebrities. Score, please.
The score 11, making the total 30.
Not a very good round for celebrities, but they've got 30 and they're in the lead at the moment with Stuart.
Thank you, Eddie. The head waiter game now to end them all on my right. It's Fraser Hines. Next to him, Robin Askwith. Hey. Over there we have, oh, flipping heck, we've got Keith Chegwin and Eddie Capelli, and they're carrying the mortarboard, on top of which are balanced four buckets of water. They have their feet tied together. They have to essay their way down the course, and there's a cylinder at the other end. Arthur.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
Right.
1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2,
and Fraser Hines, they are shouting. Bernard Cribbins is there dancing attendance to make adjustments if necessary. Keith Chegwin of Swap Shop at the back, Eddie Capelli, who's a well-known wrestler also. They've made one run. In goes the water, back go the boys. And you'll give them a small cheer if you like. It's up to you. 1 minute to go, fellas. You can make another run. Two runs will count. Quickly! Come on, you're running out of time, lads. Come on! Come on!
One, two!
You've half a minute! It's half a minute to go, lads. Come on, up, up and at them. Come on, lads. Come on, any old run will do. Bernard Cribbins, intent on doing a bit of damage. He's gone down. The lot's gone. Right, Arthur, meanwhile.
And the score for the celebrities, 12 marks on the dipsticks.
12 on the dipsticks for the celebrities. Now we'll go the Taverners. And competing for Lord's Taverners, give them a big cheer, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Liverpool Express. And Arthur, let's get on the way.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
12 marks on the dipstick to go. And if they can keep it together. Keep it together, lads. You've lost one bucket already. You can't do that. Sam said. Emperor Ellis is instructing the boys how to do the game. You can't hold the buckets, you can hold the board. The Liverpool Express for Lord Stavridis, can they do it?
Just there now. Okay,
stop. 10 marks on the dippy sticky.
Keep it up.
To win. Now, getting back is the problem. The celebrities couldn't quite make a second run. Now, come on, lads, get it together. Liverpool Express, well named. The crowd are shouting in, out. Give them in, out, then. Come on, in, out, in, out, in. Oh, the faster we are. And I think there'll be some sabotage coming now. Yes, I expected trouble from that direction. When Askwith and Hines get together, murder will ensue. The lot's coming in. Make another run, the Express. Make another run. 30 seconds to go. In the meanwhile, get up the mortarboard and come on.
Come on, lads, make a go. A bit of sabotage there from the celebrities, the Lord's Taverners. Can they do it? 10 seconds to go. And the whistle goes. Stop! Wait a minute, Arthur. First of all, you've got to have a look.
Yes, well...
Have you seen it?
Oh, yes. Actually, anticipating what were going to happen, I already measured it when they'd had the first run. The Lord Taverner's got 10 marks on the dipstickers against Celebrities 12. The winners, Celebrities. 2 points for the Celebrities.
2 points for the Celebrities. And...
1 point to Lord Taverner.
1 point to Lord Taverner. So, ladies and gentlemen, the score now is the Celebrities 7, the Lord Taverner's 8. Eddie, with you.
Well, Lord Taverner is 7 behind in the marathon. They should make it up on this round, as long as there's not a lot of opposition. The whistle.
3, 2, 1.
And a lot of personalities. Bob Wilson, Eric Flynn, here they come. Kenneth Woolsnow and Bernard Bresslaw. And would you believe it? The chairman of Chelsea. The chairman of Chelsea did a great job for the team. Aye, aye. Here's what they call flat out. It's Kenneth. Kenneth Woolsnow. Peter Glaze.
There you go.
There are the girls. Here comes the legs and coat. Got 30 seconds at the top. 30 seconds. Left. Oh, that was what we call a knock on. Come on, boys, you haven't a lot of time. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. There was Derek Hobson trying to put it off the count in then. Well, they all had a bash. Don't know how many they got. You're going to find out right now how many, please.
They scored 30, making the total 53.
You wouldn't believe that. A record for all time. 53. That was very good. If you cared, 53. Back to Stuart.
Thank you, Eddie. And now we have Linda Cunningham here in a wheelbarrow. Beautiful little girl being pushed by a mysterious Mr. X. Over here in the celebrity wheelbarrow, the beautiful Susan Hampshire. Ask me what?
I was going to tell him how to get there. That was all.
You're telling him how to get there. It's entirely up to you because he's blind.
Yeah, I'm looking at the point.
You're another Mr. X. You are not allowed to look.
All right.
Because the two girls have got to instruct the two boys who are blindfold how to get down the course, round the obstacles, which are balloons in this instance, over the rickety bridge, across the finishing line. Good luck, Susan, and good luck, Linda.
Oh, my God.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
Go. Sharp right.
Left, sharp right. Sharp right.
Susan
sharp
Hampshire is guiding her, Mr.
Sharp
X.
Right.
Linda
sharp
Cunningham,
right.
Hers.
Left.
Susan Hampshire.
Sharp right. Left. Whoa. Left, sorry. Well done.
Of the
sharp
palaces.
Turn. Right. No right
the beautiful
again.
Beautiful dulcet
the
tones.
Right.
Leading
right,
at the moment,
the right.
Beating the Lord's
right.
Taverners.
Sharp left. Right.
There's
right.
Linda Cunningham.
Sharp right. Sharp right. Right. Further right.
Straight, straight, up the ramp. One. Up, 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 up.
Linda.
Left wheel. Left wheel.
But meanwhile.
Left.
Over
left,
the bridge, over
right.
The rickety bridge,
right.
Has gone Mr. X
sharp,
with Susan Hampshire
right.
on the back
right,
run,
right,
the second
right,
leg of the journey. And he's got it stuck. There is going to be a collision. He's going to spill Susan.
Right. We'll have to start it again. Right. We're going to bump into this lot. 1, 2, 3. Up.
And Mr. X with Linda has missed the rickety, rickety bridge.
It's all right.
We
all
must
right.
go
we'll
over.
Go
don't spill Susan.
Fantastic.
She's over.
We're down!
Are you there?
It nearly ran away. But having cheated, having not gone over the bridge the first round, the Lord's Taverners, they always enter skullduggery into these games. Linda Cunningham.
Straight on. Right.
You can hear
right.
You can hear them shouting.
Right,
and the celebrities are all over the place at the moment. The Lord's Taverners have overhauled them. And
left.
It's not in the rules,
left.
Linda.
Left, right. Left, whoops, left.
You have 10 seconds to go, Susan and Linda.
Right a bit, this plate over.
Straight.
Arthur says do another leg.
Right.
Arthur says turn round.
Keep going straight forward.
Another lap.
Straight on with all your might. Straight.
A straight run back as fast as you can go. Straight run. Fast as you can. It's a straight race. And the celebrities. Left a bit, celebs. Left. Right a bit. Going over the top.
It's
going to win it. Celebrities have won it. Susan Hampshire, we shall now reveal the identity of the man who won this valiant race. Off he comes. It's Bob Grant from On the Buses. Rough applause, please, for Bob from On the Buses. No, and I'll progress now. No, don't take him off yet. No. With Linda was the man you love to hate. Ladies and gentlemen, take off the blindfold. None other, Mick McManus. Hey! Oh, did he hear? Mick, did he hear the booze? Arthur, you're a prognost.
Yes, well, with a bit of bending of the rules, celebrities were the winners. 2 points to the celebrities.
Celebrities, 2 points on the scoreboard, the lovely Dinah and the Lord Taverners.
1 point to Lord Taverners.
1 point to Lord Taverners. It's 9 apiece as we go to Eddie.
Well, there it is, and it's all go of this end because we're coming to the vital point of the marathon. 30, 53 celebrities to go. They need a lot. They say they're going to get a lot. We'll see on the whistle.
3, 2, 1.
Off you go, boys. A lot of them up there. Headed by Fraser Hines, Robin Askwith, Derek Hobson, Gillian Gilks, Nicky Henson, Hilary Fisher, Raymond Baxter, Eddie Capelli. They're all coming up. Why? Never seen anything like this. The slight to success. The last time that... Keep going because we've got a good girl keeping count. She knows what she's been pinched. 30 seconds to go. Come on, Raymond. Kenneth, 30 seconds. Oh, you're cheated, are you? Where are the boys? They're all having a go now, the celebrities. They're really putting on strength. Raise the line, you bastard line. 10 seconds. 9, 8. 7, come on, 6, Derek, come on, 4, 3, 2, 1. How many, Derek? Okay. Right.
Okay. They scored 43, making their total 73.
73, if you understand it, hope you're enjoying it. Back to Stuart.
And thank you very much indeed, Eddie. And now for a snatch of a song.
There's a ship lies rigged and ready in the harbour. Tomorrow for old England, she sails.
Who is it? It's Roger Whittaker, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Hey, get back inside, you he-man, you. He has to roll a drum. And he goes down the course, and there you see... PC Frank Windsor. Let us start.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
Rog Whittaker with the elastic tonsils propels the cylinder down the course to pick up Frank Windsor. Against the clock, Roger, as fast as you can, picks up Frank. They both stop! Come back! And when they come back, they pick up Patty of Legs and Co. Your top of the pops. Terpsichorean dancers. Come on, lads, it's against the clock. This is not an amble before tea. Back. You have 1 minute to complete it. Give them a cheer as they go.
So come on, we're over the finishing line now. Frank, Roger, Patty, all frills. They finish. Now give a cheer, come along. Prance about, show the frills, back to the start. Emote.
And the time for the celebrities, 1:31.
That was slow, 1:31. A very slow time for the celebrities, the Lord's Taverners.
Arthur. Ready? 3, 2, 1.
We're on our way. What can I say but hello, Cheeky. In the drum, a welcome, please, for John Junkin. Go on, give him a big welcome. That is a lovely technique. Very dexterous. And he picks up the ever lovely, slim and trim, Alan Freeman. A little applause for Alan Freeman, please. Come along. You've got to cheer the heroes this afternoon. Up with the clock. Alan, can you breathe in a bit, Alan? It's showing. Breathe in. And a lady from Samstead has been taken into protective custody. Let her free. She gets in. They roll back. What's the time, Arthur? How are we doing? 1 minute. They've had a minute now. You're up with the clock. Lord's Taverners, you could come in with a win. It's all turning very nasty. Somebody send for Superintendent Barlow. Hello. Fluffy's losing his temper. Temper, temper. And it's a lovely shot. Beautiful, they finished now. Here they come. John Junkie, what a great game you played. Have you any comment to make at all on them tactics of yours?
I will never buy another Roger Whittaker record again.
Right, my love.
Well, even with a bit of cheating from Roger Whittaker and Frank Windsor, they still didn't beat the time. 1:28 for Lord.
1:28, you won by 3 seconds.
Lord Taverners are the winners. 2 points to Lord Taverners.
2 points to the Taverners, and up they go on the scoreboard, pricked by the lovely Dinah. And
1 point to the celebrities.
One for the celebrities, and the score at the moment, celebrities 10, Taverners 11, the last time, Uncle Eddie.
Well, let's give you the situation. 73 for the celebrities. You're dying. Get out with you. Get out with you. Then it was 53. So, right, on the call for the last marathon.
3, 2, 1.
Off you go. This is it. They're all in full force. Oh, they got mad now. So it's everybody for themselves now. These celebrities, the Lord Taverners. I am Bernard Bresslaw. That was the beautiful bearded Bernard Bresslaw. 30 seconds, boys. There's plenty of talent at the top. Never have so much talent gone down a slide. Well, either way, well, this is what they call the... It's all right. You're all on the same side. You're getting very, very close. You're about a couple of seconds. Hurry up now. Well, we will now have the final total for the Taverners.
They scored 20, making their total 73.
Well, how remarkable. That's brilliant. The celebrities have got 73. Lord Taverners have got 73. So, on to the master scoreboard. 4 points for the celebrities. And 4 points for the Lord Taverners. Which means that it's all on the last game with Stuart.
Oh, what a lovely resounding phrase, Eddie. And with me, I've got Muriel Tufnell here carrying buckets of water on our usual carts. And I'll just put her hat on because she's competing for the celebrities. Make you ever lovely, my sweet. Over here for the Lord's Taverners, the jockey is Anita Harris. You didn't see that.
I'll tell you more about the propulsion later on. We'll get them on their way. They measure the water. Oh, the hats have come off. Oh, swipe me. Never mind. They're down the course. It's a measuring job in the cylinders. As much water as you can carry, my girls. Right, Arthur.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
So get the cheers going. Now, do I have some for celebrities? And what about the Lord's Taverners? Nothing. Both of them put the water in.
Okay.
It's not how many runs you can make in the time, limit time. It's how much water you can pop in. Back at the start. And we've only got one, two hats on. Diving in, merry old Tufnell is on her way, propelled by Ronald Leigh-Hunt and Nicky Henson, but being overhauled by Anita Harris, that's Meryl, enjoying every second, European champion woman jockey. Anita Harris, les chanteuses, pop the water in, on your way back, in the nightshirts. Anita Harris, Meryl Tufnell, Ken Wartenholme, and Roger de Courcey pulling the Lord's Taverner's truck. Mary O'Tuffnell smiling all the way through it. Every year she competes in this same event, usually versus Anne Moore, who unfortunately can't be with us today. But those two boys are showing every sign of fatigue. Ken Wartenholme, Roger de Courcey. Nookie Bear, come on! Get it going, Nita! And a drop of water goes over the willing horses. I think the lads are tiring. The spirit's willing, but the flesh is rather weak. We could allow substitutes. We could allow substitutes. There might be a little fouling. I look over my shoulder, there could be some fouling. At the moment, the Taverners appear to be... No, it's the celebrities, I think, in a slight lead. But at the start, I think there's going to be a little water thrown. And the horses get soaked, Anita gets the lot, the head waiters are in. Chaos rules, and that's about it. I don't think anybody's going to make any more runs at all. Yes, they are. Stop, stop, the carts are coming down. Get the lids on Arthur and Flynn. Get the lids on, the lot's going over. Boom. We shall shortly nip in. And there it is. We'll have a result before it goes everywhere. It's going over Lance Percival. Meryl Tufnell's in there. Judy Chalmers is in, and we'll give a result. Yep. Arthur, quickly.
We'd already got the result before.
I knew you had.
And the marks on the dipsticks.
Yes.
Celebrities 12, yes. Lord Taverners 10. Celebrities are the winners. 2 points to the celebrities.
2 points to these celebrities.
1 point to Lord's Taverners.
One to Lord's Taverners. And would you believe it's even Stevens? The contest has finished. 16 points apiece. We can't allow that to happen. So we're going to have a final race. And the final race will be between the contestants who competed in the last event. Anita Harris of the Lord's Taverners bouncing around. Meryl Tufnell in the sacks. Down the course they go, and they're all eager to see where the destination of the current trophy goes. Except they say, hang on a minute. Arthur, straight down the course they go, set them on the way.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
Back you come to the start. We can't allow any cheating today. Wait for 3, 2, 1.
She's up!
No, no. Oh, look at this. Don't worry. Don't worry about it. You wait for the 3, 2, 1 and go. Arthur, come on.
3, 2, 1.
So it's Anita Harris in the lead for the Lord's Taverners. Meryl Tufnell coming up. At the moment, it's Lord's Taverners. Now Anita Harris, she put off by Neil Durden-Smith. More cheating again by the Taverners. It's going to be Meryl Tufnell in things now. Anita Harris in now. And once again, more cheating from Neil Durden-Smith and Raymond Baxter, and they are incorrigible. You sort that out.
The celebrities are the winners. Meryl Tufnell just won it.
The celebrities are the winners. Put them up. 1 point, 17 to 16. And So the trophy goes to the celebrities. A little cheer for celebs, please. Come on. Eddie.
Thank you very much. Well, we officially declare the winners as the celebrities and to present the trophy to the winning captains. Susan Hampshire, did you enjoy your day out, Susan?
Yes, thank you very much, and I haven't got wet yet.
You haven't got wet. Well, here's Bill Oddie to receive the cup as the celebrity champion, yes?
Thank you, team, yes, thank you. I'm glad it wasn't me out there.
You're feeling better?
Very much better now, yes.
After this, you're very pleased.
Yeah, nothing wrong with me, I just didn't want to be...
yeah,
never worse. Come on, then, well, say goodbye.
Hope you've enjoyed it.
Say goodbye, everybody. Goodbye.
Goodbye.